Hello, we're the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Today we have a bunch of different SpaceX updates to start this episode. After which we also have a bunch of activity in Boca Chica as well as Starship updates with SN5 and SN8. Let's head straight in and get up to date. To begin with, we now have an update on when to expect the next Starlink launch. As you can see on the SpaceX fans website, Starlink 9 along with two other satellites are scheduled to launch Friday, July 31st at 7:45am UTC or 3:45am EDT. There has also been some more specific details on the Crew Dragon Endeavour return with Bob and Doug. This tweet from Eric Burgess says NASA is currently targeting 2:35pm Eastern Time on Sunday, August 2nd for the landing of the Dragon Ship Endeavour mission. When it comes to Crew Dragons, there was recently a meeting of the NASA Aerospace Safety Advisory Panel where some interesting things were said. Panel member Don McCurlin said that landing the Demo 2 mission will be a challenge because of the limited wind margins on this capsule. Have 7 landing sites to choose from off east and west coasts of Florida, up from 3. Then, McCurlin said NASA's plans call for reusing the Falcon 9 booster from the Crew 1 mission on the Crew 2 mission and to reuse the Demo 2 capsule for Crew 2 as well. To add to this, Thomas Burchhart tweeted that the booster for this mission would be B1061 and the capsule would be C206. Further on the talk of boosters and Crew Dragons, here we have B1058 in a great shot from Julia Bergeron. Whilst the men it launched to space on its first flight are still in orbit, this vehicle has already been back up and returned from its second mission. You can see it's still sporting those NASA logos from the Demo 2 mission. Finally, on the standard SpaceX update, SpaceX is going to be looking at raising more money soon. They are apparently looking to raise between $500 million and $1 billion to bring their valuation to $44 billion. With all the usual SpaceX updates covered, let's take a look at the workover in Boca Chica. Starting off the updates for this video, we'll take a look at the launch and test area. Here, you can't see much, but this is the latest view of the Super Heavy launch pad. Next up, we have the structure recently spotted over by the test mount where SN5 currently sits. You can see they've progressed further, will be interesting to see what this building is used for. Over by this area, workers were also spotted working on the fence just next to this new building. Not sure what exactly they are doing, but maybe they are just planning to replace the fence. Also spotted recently were some new arrivals as you can see here. These are for the construction and transport mounts we often see, and with activity ramping up, makes sense that they'd need more. Over in the production area of the facility, we have some new work that has recently been happening. Currently being attached to the new ground fabrication building is yet another structure. Also in the construction area, workers have been continuing with the high bay construction. They've already nearly completed all corners for the second level, so the next step is some more work to connect these, then the high bay can start leveling up again. We've also recently seen some work such as cleaning happening with the old Mark 1 fins. They've been moving further, and while SpaceX's intention was to reuse these fins, it's not quite the reuse one would expect. They won't see another Starship again. Instead, they are being reused as a garden ornament as you can see here. At the food court, SpaceX have built this structure to shade people from the sun, and I think it looks really, really cool. So with the infrastructure updates in Boca Chica covered, let's take a look at what's been happening Starship-wise. First up, we have a fella we've seen many times, Starhopper. As you can see, engineers were spotted making some unknown modifications to the retired vehicle. In the last video, we took a little look at some work that has recently been going on with the SN2 test tank. You can see here that workers have been continuing to work on it with some weird and interesting additions. Will be very interesting to see what this becomes. Expected, but still thought I'd show it, we have some more rings moving around the yard with this one heading into a fabrication tent. I expect that SN9 is already probably in the works. Behind and inside these fabrication tents, a whole load of activity was spotted again. You can see here a bit of nose sitting outside. This little nose cone tip was spotted and is likely destined to be scrapped. However, inside the tent just behind, this nose cone was also spotted under construction. As you can see from Jack Bayer's editing, this nose apparently has a header tank weld. Here we have a view of part of SpaceX's collection of nose cones. From Jack Bayer's great editing again, we can see that one of these noses outside has a header tank weld and the other doesn't. Here we have the latest view of the new fairing section being welded partially in the windbreaker. Also, as the editing points out, this nose cone doesn't have a header tank. The header tank up there I believe is for oxygen, and there is another below the methane tank to store methane. The header tanks separate the landing propellant from the main propellant tanks, apparently for greater insulation. At some point, the new nose cone section was moved outside the fabrication tent. So the company has a lot of nose cones at the moment. It's crazy cool to see so many. However, yesterday there was a tropical storm that was approaching the Boca Chica area. As a result, you can see here that the new nose cone was moved back inside the tent. Also, just to be safe, they decided to move all of the nose cones back inside the tent to seek shelter from the storm. Some of you will know this, but back in the early Boca Chica days, SpaceX were building a nose cone for Starhopper. However, due to strong winds, that was blown over and destroyed, so SpaceX didn't bother with it again. With this level of progress, they definitely don't want to risk something like that happening again. Moving on from the nose cones, here we have a view of the SN5 tank that is still waiting for a static fire test with Raptor SN27 attached. Yesterday, SpaceX were gearing up and even closed the road in preparation for the static fire test. However, due to the tropical storm, this was aborted early into the window when they reopened the road. So with no testing yesterday, we'll look at what days we could expect to see the static fire happen. As of now, the Cameron County website shows a closure for the static fire on Monday, July 27th. Hopefully, the static fire test will happen over the next few days, then next week there could be a 150 meter hop. Final Starship to look at is the start of the newest Starship prototype, SN8. Last episode we saw this newly sleeved common bulkhead that was sitting behind the onion tents. Engineers were recently spotted getting ready to flip this section. Then, it wasn't very long before they hooked it up and did the flip. So this section, which will separate the methane and oxygen tanks, is almost ready to be hooked up with other stacks. Also, another ring stack, which is slightly different to what we've seen before, was moved outside for SN8. Also, this new upper bulkhead for the methane tank was spotted being moved outside onto a sleeving mount. As expected, these two components were sleeved to form the upper stack for the tank. However, as I just mentioned, you can see some interesting welds on top of the ring stack, similar to what is commonly seen on the thrust sections. Like we see with the thrust sections, these are reinforcements inside the barrel section. However, as you can see from Jack Bayer's editing, this is the first time we've seen it on a forward dome section like this. Then, just as with the other Starship sections and with the tropical storm approaching, this new section was also moved inside. Whilst the storm is another minor little setback, we can hopefully still expect the exciting testing very soon. As always, an enormous thank you goes to Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Girl, for her time and dedication filming this stuff. She, Jack Bayer, Julia Berdron, and everyone else at NASA Spaceflight do a fantastic job bringing us great updates and information, so thank you all. That's it for this episode of The SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.